I would like to welcome, please stand with me as I welcome the class of 2019.
Thank you. We also want to welcome James Robertson. He's our guest speaker. We'll hear more about James a little bit later. We also want to recognize all our parents, grandparents, everyone's been with us that helped our kids get to this point. And we also want to recognize two special guests tonight. Mr. Holloman, who will please stand up.
Good evening. Good evening, class of 2019. Parents, guardians, faculty, distinguished guests. My name is Mike Letcher, and I have the pleasure of serving as chairman of the Eastwick Academy Board of Directors. Tonight, I have the honor of inducting 41. Forty-one new members into the Eastwick Academy Eagle Society. The Eagle Society is a very special designation given to those students who have completed 13 years of schooling at Eastwick Academy. They have met the demand requirements of our college preparatory curriculum and fulfill academic standards pursuant to the criteria of the North Carolina Department of Public Instruction. These students not only accomplish these requirements, but also demonstrate high values and notable character during their 13-year enrollment at Eastwick Academy. Tonight, these 41 new members will join the previous Eagle Society members who have been inducted in past years. As I call the name of our newest Eagle Society members, I ask that the parents and guardians of these students stand as well. We would like to honor these graduates, but also, just as importantly, we want to recognize your dedication and enduring commitment to Eastwick Academy. The inductees for the Eagle Society class of 2019 are Rachel Blackman, Cindy Brown, Avery Brown, Diana Brown, Lauren Brown, Michael Brown, basketball team, Dalton Berger, Diana Berger, Chloe Gamble, Haley Carter, Haley Connor, Thomas Cooper, Natalia Hall, Cody Hardy, Ruby Hammonds, Gracie Hodge, John Long Hughes, Kristen Hunter, Andrew Johnson, Ty Day, Jacob Keller, Allison Keys, Addison Cove, Anna Lefino, Matthew Montgomery, Jordan Moore, Nate Paul, Irene Peralta, Zoe Peralta, Charlie Barrier, Emily Tyler, Noah Brinker, Grace Brinker, Lindsey Simmons, Joseph Sullivan, Bill Taylor, Christine Terwilliger, Haley Tuck, Kiana Neville,
not to expose, but I ask them to write some color usually at the end of the year, and it has As 2019 finally comes to a close, we sit to remember times gone by. Your cap sits up, your gown, it flows. The time for graduation is nigh. Room 211 is all almost all while, only two of you managed to miss. Quiet Angel and Charlie, all a smile. Of my class, you will not remiss. The fall had seniors ready for fun. The knees were often covered with braces. Taylor Hansley and Chloe Campbell thought dancing days were done, and Jackson hobbled along with their paces. Some of you I'll see very often, and many of you I wish you well. For Crowder and Andrew Leonard, my heart does soften as you watch my car all go. But see them, they do a great job. Tip well. Those smaller classes are really like ours. 12 students was all third period boasted. Gracie was only one of the two gals, while Will by Asa and Aaron was roasted. They on couches they sat with smiles every day. Sweet Noah, Sam Newton, and Matthew were there. And Dawson would shake his head in dismay when chats of Othello would go everywhere. For some, hard lessons were learned and were taught. Our Adam drives a bit differently now. And Cameron, I hope, drives more like he ought instead of his exit from parking he flaps. Now some had English and mythology too. Jacob and Jared on errands would run. Zoe and Ivanovsky danced right through, and Grace's prayers are second to none. You pray for me, I'll pray for you. The class of 19 with talents they're endowed, Kaylee's drawings and artwork display her skill. Taylor Jones and Ashley Perry danced circles around, and Christine made an awesome dragon, for real. You guys should see this then, it's amazing. I love it. For Austin Bassett and Landon, singing is their thing, and Ruby and Lauren are softball pros. Anna's book sculpture is amazing, and Nathan built an entire boat. But it was an entire boat, the whole time. Max is a hunter, his dog is top notch, and Nate, he shoots competitively. At Chick-fil-A, Chloe Quinn rules the watch with workers and customers repetitively. This graduating class has lots of Haleys. Caudle's love for Pudge is unparalleled. Miss Tuck can sing lots of ladies' vocals. I tried to write that. And Turner's cross-country records for Yale. In 211, seating means a lot, with 28 in a class, it's true. Rachel chose the floor for her spot. Enrique chose the window view. The MGP's our biggest feat, as pictures and posters did abound. Brianna's face on her poster was neat. And Michael's record wasn't quite round. In theme and film, as freshmen sat, Violet, Savannah among the crew, the chance one takes with shared documents, then Cody and Ty circling test tubes. Our group in Europe had a time so swell. Emily looks great in a beret. I have a picture of her. Diane Burke navigates Paris well. Madison's sarcasm is my favorite kind, and Dalton has a comeback or two. Carlos knew everyone where to find, but often he really had no clue. Don't tell me somebody fell down some stairs one day. For Ashley Davis, the hot tub was where she sat, while reading for me something expositive. And every day when I might not last, Joseph Payne Ruth is stay positive. Thank you, Joseph. I knew that. John Norman Hughes, for greatness is destined. He does everything with precision and grace. And Caitlin Etheridge knows what to be dressed in. Her blue velvet prom dress was super and ace.
It was beautiful.
Some seniors are known for unique qualities. Andy Johnson, of course, has really long hair. And Jada's sweet smile knows no equalities. When she greets you, you feel like she's happy she's there. With Shakespeare, any soul to pierce, LaViva and Cheyenne make his words ring true. Though she be but little, she's fierce. The world will know when they come through. You're off to great places we can't wait to see. Up the college ladder, for sure you're a climber. To ECU, Caitlin Maynard and Kristen will be. To USC goes Lindsay Marcus-Heimer. I want to be Marcus-Heimer. Our own Tiana is headed for the hills. A panther is Carly to High Point with a shout. Addison will like heights at ASU with squeals. And sweet Jordan to Meredith, an angel no doubt. You're most off to college, some loved and some hated. For Skylar and others, NC State has their back. Remember what Kipling said in Poetry Stated, the law that the strength of the wolf is the pack. First period competed for tardies the most, with Simmons and Addison in fourth, with 14. Jacob 20 got second. He was first on those. Diana Brown's 25. Natalia was always ready for tea. David had excellent paragraphs. And Kayla's 11-22-63. Fourth period on the show of the class, on clogging, Hannah was often instructed. It's not just English there to pass. Sydney learned how to not be loved. Don't forget that. Thank goodness for Weston, the TA I got. He helped me daily without any fuss. Is this the last time I'll see him? Absolutely not. There's too much Netflix left to discuss. So now, as we honor your daughters and sons, remember that God gave each of you voices. There are no wrong answers, only unsupported ones. Now go forth, my lovelies, and make your choices.
In English and American history, from time writings with Mrs. Massey and Mrs. Tower to DBQs with Mr. Harrington, we learned how to effectively defend our points as well as how to work well under pressure. On top of the meaning of stop and TOA in the unit circle, math has taught us problem solving. And if you didn't retain any of that information, at least you know how to rock the color orange at a pep rally 3 years in a row. Once we leave high school, we'll be free from the norms and the rules that we follow. We'll soon forget about uniforms, smart lock, and IRB tests, but we'll always remember to hold ourselves to a higher standard and to carry ourselves like we belong at the top, because that is what has been instilled in us at our time at East Wake Academy. So as we go on to our personal endeavors, I would like you to remember this quote from the great Aubrey Graham. Sometimes it's the journey that teaches you a lot about the destination. Overall, our class has made some great memories at the school, from Camp Flintlock, Falkland Island, winning the Spirit Stick in 7th grade, and that strange time period when we were all obsessed with silly bands, double tape, and put mustaches on everything. If we could overcome that time period of our lives, we can overcome anything. Our class knows that in every speech I give, I use the phrase, we're all headed in one direction, mostly for the fun, but also to emphasize that in our transitions throughout middle and high school, we grew up together and experienced similar growing pains. However, for the first time, this statement no longer holds true as we're all going down different paths in life. But one thing we'll always have is our shared experience at this great school. So if the class of 29 can repeat after me, we are conquerors.
We are conquerors.
We are successful.
We are successful.
We are more than meets the eye.
We are more than meets the eye.
We are the class of 2019.
We are the class of 2019.
Good evening, class of 2019. We made it. We have finally conquered and overcome the easiest part of our lives. Now it's time for the real challenge, adulthood. We now go out to the real world and either sink or swim. We get to enjoy our independence while jumping through the obstacles life throws at us. I have no doubt that each and every one of you can be successful going into the next chapter of your lives. I'd like to take a moment on behalf of myself and my fellow graduates to thank the people that have brought us here. While all the staff members present have influenced different students in positive ways, two teachers that come to my mind are Mr. Holloman and Ms. Higgins. Both people have big hearts and truly care about our well-being as well as our academic success. Mr. Holloman is someone who didn't know a single morning or who wasn't waiting at the top of the staircase to say good morning to each and every student by name. As he leaves the school with us, he would be leaving some big shoes to fill. And Ms. Evans not only dealt with our senior college planning, but she also helped many people like myself figure out exactly what I wanted to do and how to obtain it. I think I emailed and talked to her as regularly as I did my academic teachers. It is this attention and care from teachers that make this school so great. But staff members are not the only people that deserve tremendous thanks. Our families have been our constant supporters, from having to sit through carpool before we could all drive, to dealing with our college planning and hectic breakdowns. My family has been my biggest support throughout high school and my life. My parents have always pushed me to do my best and find enjoyment in what I do. I honestly believe I would not be up here delivering this speech to you today if I did not have them in my life to persuade me that I could obtain anything I put my mind to. Similarly, I am thankful for my siblings, Hannah, Carlton, and Hope, and for my boyfriend, Logan Meadow, who have all supported me immensely throughout high school. But back to my main focus, the class of 2019. I am thankful for each and every one of you, who I'm sure I've been good friends with at one time or another over my past 11 years at East Wake Academy. As we leave here today, it is important to take with us what we have learned throughout these past 4 years of high school. Freshman year, we learned that if we make enough student council speeches about getting more chairs, we will get some new chairs. Sophomore year, we learned which DJs, not care about senioritis and the power it had over all of us. But more seriously, we learned how to make mistakes and overcome them. These last 2 years especially allowed us the opportunity to earn respect from our peers and teachers. We were given the chance to put our best selves forward and grow from our mistakes and failures. As we enter into our new lives, I want all of you to be okay with failing rather than being afraid of the idea. Failure is inevitable, but it is all about how you grow from that failure and what you learn from it. We should learn from our mistakes and grow from them. Many people use failure as an excuse to give up, however, I challenge you to do the opposite. As Thomas Edison said, many of life's failures are people who did not realize how close they were to success when they gave up. Edison also believed that when faced with a mistake, we ultimately have three choices. One, we can allow mistakes to discourage us. Two, we can ignore mistakes. Or three, we could grow from them. While many of us utilize the first two options throughout high school, it is important that as adults, we solely choose the last option of learning from them. Letting mistakes discourage you is not good for yourself or those around you, and ignoring them will only result in poor outcomes. For instance, I made the mistake of thinking I could juggle school, year-round sports, a job, and volunteer work without breaking a sweat. However, I underestimated the amount of sleep a person really needs, and I ended up having a total meltdown on the basketball court sophomore year, which I can laugh about now, but if I had let that discourage me, or if I had ignored the problem, I would not have learned good time management or self-discipline. Our third option of learning from our mistakes is the one that will result in the most long-term happiness and future success. So class of 2019, learn from your mistakes and never give up or settle for anything less than what you want. Because you each deserve everything you want out of life, but you cannot obtain that if you let yourself sink from your mistakes. So be confident in everything you do, do not be afraid to make mistakes, and do not let others influence you otherwise. It is this unfaltering optimism that we should bring with us into the future. I encourage all of you to go into this next chapter of our lives with an open mind and a confident attitude. So as you go to college, or the workforce, or wherever life is leading you, and things don't go your way, try to stay confident, learn from your mistakes, and hold your head high. Thank you.
This is an exciting time for me as an educator. It always
and the Eluxians, class of 2019. Congratulations. I'm excited to speak with you today because I strongly believe in education and the opportunities it brings to those who pursue it with a determined mind. Seeing you in the audience this evening is inspiring because your actions going forward will determine so many enemies in your life. You have accomplished a milestone that you will never forget. High school graduation is the beginning of adulthood. It's the beginning of dreams and career pursuits. I'm sure you're anxious to know what your future holds for you. I'm here to tell you that your future is bright. It is impossible for you to fail. As long as you are committed and you have the fortitude to be successful, you can accomplish anything that your heart desires. When I graduated from high school, I had a plan. But I learned in life that you don't always have it all figured out. I went off to college and I decided that I wanted to work in radio and television, and I was fortunate to do so for about 7 years. Then I decided that I wanted a career change. I decided to go back to school to get my master's in library and information science, and I was then introduced to the community college system. Today, I am fortunate to serve as an administrator of the largest community college in the state of North Carolina, where we serve some 74,000 students. And it has been rewarding for me because I have an impact on the lives that we're able to change, transforming lives, helping students succeed, creating job opportunities. It has been one of the most rewarding experiences one can ever imagine. Opportunities will present themselves to you in ways that you can never imagine. So always keep your eyes open and listen. I'm sure you've heard it from your parents, and it is very true. You will make progress in life by simply taking one step at a time. I strongly believe in community service and paying it forward because it contributes to the success of humanity. I remember faculty and administrators as I was pursuing both my undergraduate degree and my master's degree, taking me by the side and having these personal conversations, providing the guidance and the necessary tools and resources to help me succeed. My mother, who worked hard, prepared for this journey. She instilled in all of her kids it was important to pay it forward once you succeed. Giving back and paying it forward has been easy for me because I've witnessed others doing it all my life. Your parents, mentors, and those who care about you are uplifters, so don't forget the lessons they have taught you through their generosity. I would like you to take a moment and look around this room as you're surrounded by family, friends, love, and support, especially your parents. Could we have your parents please stand for me? All parents, please stand. Thank you. When you look back on this day, remember how proud everyone was of you. And let the love and encouragement propel you to move forward. Don't ever forget that human contact is precious. So every now and then, it's okay to put down the cell phone. As an elected official, it excites me when I have the opportunity to have conversations with my neighbors, with my constituents, with members of the community. There is nothing like that one-on-one contact. So it is okay to put down your cell phone and to have that conversation. You will be amazed at what will come out of it. class of 2019 have so much going for you. You're smart, you're ambitious, you're thoughtful young adults. During the next steps of your journey, remember that your decisions have consequences. Now I know that the summer is upon us. I know when we leave here this evening, we're going to celebrate throughout the summer. But I ask that you do it responsibly. You are now adults, and you must make those sound decisions. Be safe out there this summer. Make good decisions. Make good decisions for your friends. Always try to be kind and do a good deed for your neighbors, for your friends, for your community. This is what community is all about. This is your way of paying for and giving back. Let your light shine, because you all are stars. I wish you the very best on behalf of the town of Ninetale. Continue to forge ahead. We congratulate you. We celebrate you. We wish you the very best, and we have your back. God bless, and be well. Thank you.
Asa Lee Carter. Kaylee Nicole Carter. Haley Rose Holland. Madison Paige Cheeseman. Garrett Alexander Crowder. Joshua Thomas Fowler. Jackson Kyler Houston. Skylar Amy Trapp.
Brianna Michelle McLean.
Matthew William Montgomery. Jordan April Moore. Samuel Elijah Newton Plummer. Nathaniel Thomas Hall. Enrique Augusto Crawford. Zoe Sierra Crawford. Ashley Lynn Perry. Charles Raven Perry. Emily Cage Collins. Max Frederick Privet. Cheyenne Vaughn Wagner. Robert Weston Wall. Jared Waylon Watkins. Jayla Zanera Wiley. Landon James Williams.
Class of 2019, it is now time to do our tassels to the left.